everybody. My name is Damon Bono, creator of and at GratefullyDyed. Today we're going to go through the supplies that you're going to need to start tie-dyeing and some suggested supplies that makes it easier and that I use in my own dyes. I will also start making GratefullyDyed starter kits very soon. So, the first thing you will need to start tying is dye. I recommend getting at least your primary colors, which are red, yellow, and blue, and black, and then I personally just go and get the full rainbow and make it easier on yourself. You will need applicators for the dye. I use syringes and bottles, but anything that you can squirt dye on fabric with works. You're going to need soda ash. This stuff is very important. You put it in water to soak your shirts in prior to dyeing them, but we will get into that in a later video. You will need fabric. Any type of fabric that is natural fibers will work. That is cotton, rayon, silk, hemp, and any other natural fibers will work. You will need ties, so you can turn this to this. And last but not least, you'll need your soap, so you can turn this into this. Now for some suggested supplies that I personally use in my own dyes and that will make your dyeing life much easier. Now most of my designs start right here with any type of washable marker that you can find, and for a lot of my designs I use a pencil to start with as well. Now when mixing your dye, I suggest that you use a blender instead of just putting the dye in a bottle and mixing it up, although that will work. But when you start using your dye thickener, which prevents the dye from spreading all too much and gives you a little bit more control, it doesn't really dissolve into it very well. And then I suggest you get any type of funnel with a decent sized mouth. It'll just make your life easier. I suggest you get yourself an iron. It doesn't have to be anything great, but your fabric will wrinkle and you need it to be pretty flat when you're trying to fold designs into it. Now, I suggest you get yourself some face masks and some gloves that are comfortable for you. Don't use these things as much as I should, but they're very important, especially the face mask. If you're working with powdered dye, this stuff is very toxic. Now, when I most often use those face masks and gloves is for ice dyeing, which you don't have to have anything in particular, but I suggest you have some type of separate container for powdered dye than your big dye container. I use a brush to put it on the fabric, but you can sprinkle it on with like a salt shaker. But we'll get into ice dyes at a later time and explain more of what I'm talking about if you do not know. As I said earlier in the video, you have to get yourself some ties to tie up your fabric. A lot of people, I would go as far as saying most people, use rubber bands. I do use them for certain things, but I most of the time use this stuff, and this is Sinew. You can get it a lot of places. I do have it available on my supply site, and what you will find on there is 150-pound, as opposed to the 70-pound that you will usually find at, say, Michael's or Joann's Fabric has it, a lot of places online. And this prevents you from, when you're pulling on your shirt, snapping it, popping yourself in the face. I've done it way too many times and it's not good. So, 150-pound stuff, dyingforchange.com. It is amazing. It changed my life when I got it as far as tie-dyeing is concerned. And yeah, try it out. This is another big one. You are going to want a squirter bottle. And what this is for is when you are dyeing, if you dye with your shirt dry, which is how I usually do it, the dye will kind of just roll off. So you squirt it with this, and it makes it so the dye usually kind of just soaks in right away. Saves a lot of time, a lot of hassle, and a lot of frustration. And last, but certainly not least, you want to get yourself some heady pot, but only in states where it's legal, because at GratefullyDyed, we do not condone breaking the law. Thank you so much for watching my video. Make sure you subscribe to my channel to catch the rest as they're released. If you're excited to see what I have in store, make sure you like my videos and show them to your friends. More people watching these, the more time I can give them. Thanks again for the support, everybody. I'll get those starter kits up as soon as possible. My next video, I will show you how to set up your dye station, and then we will get right into showing you how to actually dye. See you next time.